Good morning, YouTube. The other day I was watching Walden Works Snow Bushcraft My Way, or Snow Bushcraft and Many Knives, and Sepp mentioned that his friend at Bushcraft My Way was having a 1 million view contest. Now, I haven't taken the time to check out all of this guy's channel. Just the two videos about his contest, and of course the one thing that caught my eye and I had to check out was his Great Bear Knife video. That was just awesome. What he's asking is for people to make a video and tell him, because he's a knife maker, what they like and what they don't like. And I've been planning on doing a 10 season survival video on cutting tools, so this ties into that, and also a video on what's appropriate for venture age youth to be carrying in the bush. So, first thing I want to look at, this isn't a knife, I know, this is a short sword. It's a rat tail. It is not meant for cutting. It's not meant for stabbing. It's just meant to look at. The blade I picked up at a pawn shop and I made the handle. But what I like deep, aggressive wooden grips. I do swing this around in demonstration of different sword techniques, though this is not one of my battle-ready steel blades. This is just a wall hanger, like I said. Interestingly, the ball at the end is a drawer pull that I found at a flea market or an auction a couple of years before my daughter was born, and I knew that that had to become the head on a Celtic short sword handle, and I saved it for years until I found the appropriate blade. The brass work is half inch brass rod that I shaped and ground and filed and polished and then unpolished to give it that slight patina. The handle is actually white oak floorboard that I carved while I was at a medieval reenactment. So, again, I like aggressive texturing on wooden grips. This, believe it or not, is a Korean War era US military jungle machete that a buddy of mine cut up and reformed, reprofiled, reshaped, and then he gave to me as a birthday present. This thing will cut down a 3-inch poplar in one swing. So, machetes are something that I often carry with me in the bush. That one or this one. This is the cold steel, the cheap cold steel cookery. I have cut an awful lot of branches on trails because the scouts tend to clear trails only 5 feet tall, and I'm almost 6.5 feet tall, 6 feet 5 inches. So I carry this with me all the time when we're walking trails at scout camps. It came with a semi-soft synthetic grip that I really did not like at all, so it's got a good wrap of hockey friction tape. That inspired me to buy this. This is the Hanwi cookery. Apparently these are made out of forged truck springs for the Indian police. Now, I'll tell you, whoever designed this knife must have had tiny hands, because that just beat the hell out of my hands. This is getting ground off. This is getting ground off. The back is getting ground off about like that. The front is getting ground off about like that. That's going to straighten the back out considerably and just round the front out a little bit, and the blade is going to get a reprofiling. I have a video or two of me cutting down a 10-inch dead birch with this tree, or with this tree, with this knife. And I dislike the handle architecture so much that when my wife asked what I wanted for Christmas, I told her the one thing I wanted was a 1-inch by 42-inch knife grinding belt grinder, which, being the wonderful woman she is, she got for me. Okay, so maybe I should have taken it out of the tripod to take a look at the belt grinder, but anyway. So, there's a little bit of what I like, a little bit of what I don't like. Let's get down to the simple things. I don't like metal hand grips. This is a First World War British Commando Sykes-Fairbairn. I have been carrying this since I was a rover, since I was 19, I guess, is when I got this. No, it was before I got my driver's license, so since I was maybe 17. Not a big fan of double-edged blades. That and this are the only two I have. The only reason I have this one is I forgot to bring my Skin-Do to an event in, what was that, 2008, where I was teaching axe throwing and tutoring archery. So I've picked this up from a vendor at the event and found a piece of leather lace and wrapped myself a handle. Luckily, Greg from the Leathersmiths was at that event. I scrounged a couple of pieces of offcuts of men's belt and riveted them together to make a sheath. If you don't know what a skindoo is, this is a Scottish skindoo. This is from the Scottish and Irish store. It has absolutely no edge. Decorative only. The one I carry when I have my kilt in the field generally is this one. This. Oh, you'll have to trust me, that does say Frost Mora there. This was my dad's Mora out of his fishing tackle box. And the wood handle rotted off, so I replaced it with this nice antler handle. It's a skindoo, it's supposed to be decorative, so what do I like in a knife handle? I like something that's kind of egg-shaped. Fatter and rounder at the top where it fits into the palm of your hand. Skinnier and rounder at the bottom where it fits into the crease of your fingers. Antler is perfect for this, but you go through a lot of antler looking for exactly the right piece. I've been looking for exactly the right piece for almost 6 months now. For this Mora, I bought at Lee Valley Tools. This is their 5-inch carbon steel blade. And this is the rat tail tang that I definitely do not like. I would not suggest anybody buy a rat tail knife for any kind of heavy work. My very first knife was a leather grommet handled hunting knife, very similar to this. This one was in a buddy's toolbox with a handle of duct tape because the mice had eaten the leather grommets off. When I said I could put a new handle on that for him, he said, well, if you think you can fix it, you can have it. So it's been sitting in my toolbox now for a while because I haven't got around to doing anything with it. This, I believe, is an old Frost. This is my wife's camp knife. Something else that I like. I like engraved blades, especially with Celtic knotwork. Not crazy about this handle. It's too close to being square. One of these days I'll get around to replacing the scales on it. But then I've been saying that for 30 years. I like flat-backed knives. This is the Condor Hudson's Bay knife. Very heavy knife. I like that, actually. It's got a really poorly done convex edge. Don't like convex edges at all, not for a knife. I've decided this is getting a fair bit of reshaping. This is getting ground out here. New scales going to go on up to there. And this piece is going to get ground off flat back here. Because like I said, I like flat back knives. Oh, the finish. Every Condor Hudson's Bay knife I saw on YouTube before I bought this had a painted black finish. When I ordered this, videos started coming out about how guys had what they called a nice hammer look finish. Well, I'm a blacksmith too, and the hammer look, I don't like. It means you didn't finish your job, to me. This isn't a hammer look. This is what happens when you leave a piece of bar stock out in the field for 20 years and it starts to rust and pit. Then you forge it without cleaning any of that off. So all of that's going to get ground off too. This knife is going to become a little bit lighter. As I said, I like flat back knives. This stabs me in the thumb every time I open it. This is the cold steel Trail Master. Yeah, I know, it doesn't look like that big of a knife in my hands. Like I said, I'm 6.5 feet tall. So this is going to get cut off. And then the edge is going to get redone too. I want to be able to baton wood with this. I also want to be able to slice meat with this. So I work with Venturers. Where are we here? And I bought this figuring that this would be an appropriate knife for venture age youth. Now, I had to do some hunting around to find the non-serrated edge. Gerber serrated edges are garbage. Look around on YouTube, you can see anybody who's used a serrated edge and batoned wood with it has ruined the serrated edge. But I love the sheath. I love the multifunctionality of it. I've added a few things to it myself. Titanium fork and spoon. There's no need to carry a knife to eat with if you have a belt knife. We have started getting wood ticks in the past couple of years that carry wood ticks, deer ticks, that carry Lyme disease. So in this little pouch here, I have a pair of tweezers for removing ticks. In the pocket here that's meant to hold the survival instructions, I have a dozen 20-inch 50-pound steel leaders for fishing. They make excellent snares. Of course, a roll of duct tape, Ranger bends. I have a little skinning knife in the back here. It came with a Rambo style survival knife that I bought just after the first Rambo movie was released. That knife I've since given away. I didn't like it, but I loved this piece, so I kept it. So this is one of the knives that falls into my category of knives appropriate for scout and venture age youth. These run about $60 now. If you want to get the serrated version, you can get them at Home Depot for like $35. Forgot to mention the ferrule rod incorporated in the sheath. It also has a sharpening stone incorporated in the sheath, diamond impregnated. So this is a fine knife for venture age youth. The other knife that I wanted to mention for venture age youth, I haven't got one. No, that's just not going to come through. It's the Light My Fire Swedish fire knife, and it has a fire steel that locks into the handle. So that goes into my list of what's a good knife for a venture age youth, especially at the price point of about $33. Now, as I said, I bought the Trailmaster because I wanted to be able to do some batoning. I haven't batoned any wood in 25 years since my Buck General disappeared. My Buck General, I used to baton wood with all the time. I loved that knife. It has a concave grind, the same as the, hollow ground. Same as the Buck Zipper here, which is my favorite hunting knife. I don't like the handle on it. When I bought this, they had rosewood handles available at a price of about $20 more, I think. And I've since got the chance to use them, and they feel so much nicer than these garbage rubber handles. But that is, again, a knife that is appropriate for venture age youth to carry as a camp knife. Excellent skinning knife, excellent cutting knife for meat or food. I have used this to carve spoons. Does all the bushcraft duties. Again, a flatback knife, at least as far as where your thumb goes. So there we are. What I like? I like flatback knives. I like wooden handles with aggressive carved grips. I like etched blades. I like antler handles. And I like multifunctional tools. Thanks a lot. That's it for me today. Bye now.